For a few minutes, I would like to talk to you about something. It's a very serious topic, and we get a lot of questions about it. And I believe that I can talk about it because I've experienced it. And that is the topic of dead raising. You know, people think that faith is magic, like I've said before, and they think it's just snap your fingers and this happens and that doesn't happen. And the reality is this, there's a lot to this. We'll probably do maybe several episodes of this about this because there are specific aspects that I would definitely like to go into. One of those is the fact that people say, okay, someone, I prayed for someone that was sick and now they've died. What do I do? Do I keep praying? Do I pray to raise them up? And if I do pray to raise them up, how long do I pray? Okay, there's so much that we can go into even off of that little bit. But I would say this, first off, our rule of thumb here is this. If, number one, we have to remember, there's really no recorded instances where a person was praying for a sick person, and then that person died, and then the person that was originally praying for them actually raised them up. Almost every time, especially in experience, you would see where the person that was praying for the sick, once the person died, they had to call in somebody else. Somebody else came in and actually raised them from the dead. And I think that has to do mainly with the kind of the emotional connection that's going on with the person. I'm not saying it's a hard and fast rule. I'm not saying, you know, thus saith the Lord. Like Paul would say, as one that has received grace and has experienced some things that the Lord has done through me, I believe I have the responsibility to speak on this. Now, I will tell you our position on this as far as a ministry is very simple. If someone has passed away, and we are requested to pray for